Hey guys, Colleen here, DIYer behind lemonthistle.com, and today I'm so excited to share our primary bedroom makeover with you. This has been such a long time in the making. We did this molding wall more than 2 years ago now and replaced the lights and painted it black, replaced the doors, and then we probably were gonna finish it last year, but we had a flood and all of the floors had to come back out and go back in, and we are just finally finishing it now. And so I'm excited to share it with you. Before we get into it, if you have not yet subscribed to my channel, I would love if you did that below so you don't miss out on any more DIY or home decor videos.
All right, so let's get started by looking at what this room looked like when we first moved in almost 3 years ago. So when we first moved in, it was painted kind of this beachy theme with the stripe around the middle of the room, and it just wasn't our style at all. It also had the lights sized for a queen bed, and we had a king, so you couldn't reach the light switch behind the bed to turn the lights on.
Unless we pushed the bed way over and had it off center.
So when we had the drywall finished for our kitchen, we actually moved these lights out to fit over a king bed and had the drywall patched then. We painted the room totally black and added in new baseboard, new doors, and new flooring.
And when we put the doors in, we actually closed off the closet. It didn't have a door on it before, and now it does. And we had that closet finished off one of the first things that happened when we moved into this house. It was fully unfunctional, and I do have a full YouTube video about that as well, with tips on designing a small walk-in closet.
The next thing that we did in this room is add a feature wall to the headboard wall. So this is a molding wall. It's just on the headboard wall. It is kind of a modern picture frame style feature wall. And I did a full YouTube tutorial about this project, but I broke down the math, how we installed it, and we switched out the lights to these more modern black fixtures at that time. It looked beautiful, but we never finished the room. In fact, when I shared my full home tour last year, this is what it looked like. We had a sheet pinned up over the window. We hadn't finished replacing the windows in this room. We hadn't trimmed out those windows, and then give us a year, we finished replacing the windows. We had had a flood, so we had the floors all replaced again, and we'd finally gotten some decor up on the walls. You can see that macrame piece there. But we hadn't finished styling this room. There were still some things like light switch covers that needed to be done, and we didn't have any mirrors in this room. So it was a small list of things that we needed to do to finish this off for a full makeover to be complete. And a couple weeks ago, I just decided, you know what, let's just finish it off. It took like really not that much time. So I am so excited to share the final space with you guys. And I will share what we have reused from our last house over the years and what we did get new for this space. I can't wait. I am just in love with how this space feels, and I'm kicking myself that I didn't make these small changes sooner to have this room totally finished as a refuge for us in our busy home.
Other things that we did in here to get this room ready to be completely finished is the bay window coverings. I made a whole video about that last week, how I like to dress bay windows, but this cozies up the space. It makes a nice little area for a sitting space over there. The furniture is all from Wayfair, but I needed a end table, so I used the stumps that I have had sitting in my garage since I made our living room wood round art. And these are the stumps that I used for that, for printing the wood rounds, and I just sanded them down and then gave them a coat, a really thick coat of satin exterior paint in the same color as our bedroom walls. This is the same color that we've painted doors. And those are just perfect. One is the perfect size for an end table, and one is a great plant stand to give that plant a little boost so it gets some more light in the window.
And we had left this empty before, and it's funny how adding more things into this space you would think makes it feel more crowded, but it really doesn't. It opens it up. It feels intentional. It's created this little refuge for us. I am so happy with this little nook. We ordered this chair and this lamp years ago now, I think about 2 years ago, for this space. I absolutely love them. And now that it's all set up with little end tables and this big, gorgeous Monstera here, this is my favorite little nook in the house right now. All right, so in this space, we used the same king bed and nightstands that we had in our last house. I will link that primary bedroom reveal with you. I did a YouTube video for that years ago now. That was a navy bedroom, and it also had a molding wall as a feature wall behind the headboard. We totally loved it. Going with a black molding wall, just slightly different, was just like one step further. Once you go for a dark bedroom, I feel like I don't know if we'll ever go back. We love how moody it is in here. It's just cozy. It feels safe and calming. I love black walls in a bedroom. So yes, so we use the same bed and nightstand set is from Leon's Furniture. It is solid wood and made in Canada, which is awesome. It's not maybe as modern as I would have chosen if I chose today, but it's a great quality bed. And I mean, it's a wonderful staple. The bedding is from Quilts Etc. Again, it's just a staple white duvet cover with some really great texture. I did just want to point out that I didn't go and buy any styling things for the bed or for our room. For bedding, I used to really like lots of throw pillows and lots of decor. Lately, we've actually been getting rid of a lot of those extras just so that they don't pile up beside the bed if we don't use them. This body pillow I use every night. We have our special less than beautiful pillows. I've got one that's a memory foam, so it's better for my neck, but it doesn't look as great in the pillow cover. But I've mentioned this in my home tours and room reveals before that we're kind of leaning more minimalist lately, more function, and beautiful is great, but we want it to be functional. So we use these memory foam pillows. We don't want to have extra, you know, fluffy pillows just to make it look beautiful during the day. I have no problem with how this looks. So this is what it looks like in our house every day.
And then we do have just this one pillow here that's from Rejuvenation for decor. And then that's only one pillow that's on the floor in the morning that we've got to pick up.
All right, so that is the bed, that is the bedding. Nightstand decor we keep pretty simple. We just have a couple books each, and Shane has had that polar bear for years. He totally loves it. So I left that there. I didn't change that up too much. And I just like to add fresh flowers to my nightstand whenever possible. And of course, I have a plant there. That's an aloe that my grandma gave me years ago. It keeps having babies, which is wonderful.
The pot is from a local store called Far and Wide, and they ship across Canada now. So I will link that below. It is the same place that I got the black hanging planter by the mirror as well. I love how the hanging pendants free up room on the nightstand. We put these affordable lights up when we did the molding wall. I think that they're like $34 from Globe Electric. Maybe one day down the road, that's the one thing in here I might upgrade. But for now, I think that they're so beautiful, and I love how the matte black plays against the black wall.
All right, so as far as decor in this room, we really only put up the macrame. That macrame was a DIY that I made for my room makeover at the last house as well. And my kids totally snipped the string that it's hung up with. You can see that I've tied it back together there. But beyond that, we didn't want to clutter the walls with too many things. We did get this mirror, however. This mirror we had cut at a local glass shop.
I have talked about this in videos before, but getting mirrors cut at a local glass shop can save you so much money, and you can get it exactly the size and shape that you want or need for your space. For this space in particular, the mirror that we had brought from our last house didn't fit on this wall where we'd wanted it to. The light switch was too far out and it would block it no matter how we put it. So I was able to measure the space and make the mirror narrow enough to fit equally between the wall and the door trim while leaving room for the light switch without having to go to one of those skinny over-the-door mirrors.
The rug in this bedroom is the rug that we had in our living room for the longest time. We actually had two of them. It is from Article. It's discontinued, but I love the chunky feel of it, and it is nice and cozy first thing in the morning to step onto. I think that that is it for this space. I am just so in love with how cozy it feels with the dark walls and then all the texture and all the plants. I mean, I just want to hang out in here. So in this last little refresh that I did in the past few weeks of this bedroom, the only thing that we bought is that mirror. We got that mirror made. Everything else we've had sitting around in our house for actually years. It's amazing to me what a little bit of work and kind of repurposing things can do in your home.
And I always find it funny when we finish projects like these that last 5%, you can have it 95% finished and it feels good, but not great. That last 5% is what makes a room feel amazing. So if you have a project sitting at 95%, consider this your little push to finish it off. You will not regret it.
Thank you so much for watching. I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss out on any more DIY or home decor videos. And as always, you can hit that bell to be reminded about new videos. I would love to hear from you in the comments section. What's your favorite part? Mine is, I think, the mirror. I'm super happy with the mirror.